Okay, let's play E4. Yeah, I lost a few rating points, lost a couple of games. Yeah, so back to 2-1-3-5 again. Okay, let's play the bishop's opening. Okay, knight c6. Really tempted to play the Scotch Gambit. Should I play the Scotch Gambit? Not the Scotch Gambit, what do you call this? Yeah, whatever. Let's play this. Sorry, it's Max Lynch attack if I'm right. Yeah, let's play this. So, should we play the Neckmunson Gambit? Okay, so he doesn't play. Okay, what if I play knight g5? Isn't that should I play knight g5? Should be straightforward, right? Isn't knight g5 winning? Become like some sort of pride liver attack. D takes e5. D takes e5. Okay, let's play knight g5. This is a straightforward win, I think. Winning position. Bishop e6. Okay, I'm gonna just take the bishop. Win a pawn and prevent him from castling, probably. A pawn's a pawn, so. Okay, let's take this. He has to take knight, of course, I think. Or knight a5, is it? Okay. So this is some sort of a fried liver. Yeah. Fried liver version. Should I just play knight takes f7 first or queen f3? Queen f3. Queen f3, he has bishop e6, right? So the game will go on a bit longer. I think I prefer knight takes f7. He has to take king f7 and then queen f3 check. He can't block with the knight, so if he blocks with the queen, then queen d5 check. I should be winning. Yeah, but what happens if he just run away with the king some way? Yeah, then I can just take and yeah. Either way, I think this is really good for me. I'm not bothered with the knight takes d4. I think my initiative is very strong. There has to be a win. Okay, that's the only thing that he has, I think. But okay, let's double up on this knight. Knight c3. Okay, what if he plays something like knight takes d4? Okay, he has that. Should I play something like queen e4? Queen e4 threatening queen e5. Or just play bishop g5? I think this is more straightforward. It's a more straightforward win. Okay, c6 is okay. I'm not really afraid of that because the knight is still pinned, isn't it? Okay, let's castle queen side. Okay, I'm down by a piece. I'm down a piece, but I have tremendous attack. I have to make sure I convert it. Okay, he's trying to chase away. So now I have to play some concrete stuff. Okay, if I take the knight, with the knight, of course.
Then he has to play bishop pawn takes. Then if I play something like bishop g5, he has bishop h4, he has g5. That would be a bit annoying, I think. So so let's take this. I can play queen e5, I think. No problem, isn't it? Yeah, but let's just play very forcing moves. I wanted to play bishop e7 first, just to see if he will go wrong or something like that, but I don't know. Doesn't look that good, I think. Okay, now what? Queen e4? Queen e4, he has knight g6, so okay, if I play queen e4, he plays h takes g5. Queen e5 check. King f7, his king runs away. So it doesn't look good. Why don't I just take the knight? Yes, you can take the king. Yeah, let's take the knight. I'm still down a piece, but his bishop and rook on the queen side are not participating. Okay, so now I'm gonna play this move. Yeah, so now I have a triple attack on the d5 pawn. He can't take my bishop because I have will take his queen. Oh, okay, he's taking it. So I'm still gonna be careful here because I'm still down a piece actually, isn't it? Okay, I'm gonna defend this rook. Oh, he has bishop g5 check. Is that a worry to me? Not really, right? Okay, so I'm gonna defend the pawn first. So my pawn is gonna anchor his king there. I think the check, I'm not worried about the check. I can just move, tuck in my I can just tuck in my king to b1. I think there must be a finish just now. I totally missed or something like that. I don't know. Okay, so now I think I can play queen h5 probably. I don't know. Queen e4, queen h5. Thing is, it seems to have suddenly has some counterplay. If I play queen h3 check, he's gonna run king f7. So let's play. What am I gonna do? Let's play queen h5. Yeah, so we're gonna attack from queen g6. Check. And I want to mobilize my pawns. F4, F5. Okay, we stop that. So let's go in. Yeah, I have this background. Now his bishop can go out. But that one I'm not so worried, I think. What's that? Oh, he moves his king back. Okay. Okay, should I? Okay, let's play this. I'm trying to attack his g7 pawn. I can't play e6 because he can just capture, I think. Okay, if he develops his bishop, I'm just going to take the pawn. So I think probably the only move he can play is king f8. Okay, then, but I have to do something. I cannot allow his bishop to come out because I'm down. Any move is too slow.
e6, I think he has rook f4, which is a problem. I have to find g3, I think, after this. Yeah, g3 with the idea of f4 will be some. Yeah, let's play g3. Now I'm gonna play f4, h4. So I'm gonna mobilize. Okay, he's gonna develop the bishop. So it's gonna be at the moment two bishop and a rook against my queen, rook and my queen. But I'm gonna mobilize my kingside pawns, because once he activates the rook on a8, I'm gonna be a bit. I think it's gonna be a bit problematic for me. Okay, so he's moving the rook back. I'm not sure why. Okay, let's play f4. And now I think it's a bit. Now he's finished, I think. Because he can't. Okay, stop. I think he should have just picking f8. That will be a bit difficult for me. Okay, let's just take this pawn. Okay, both of us are in time trouble here, but just, I'm gonna check first. I'm gonna take one more pawn, I think. No, I can't take the B pawn because he has rook B8. So, okay, let's make a. I'm gonna make an escape square for my king there. Just to prevent some back rank. Okay, now I'm gonna mobilize my kingside pawns, but I need some help. Okay, he wants to play rook b6. That was a very clever idea. Is he going to exchange? Okay, let's escape our king to a2 first. Okay, let's play this move. Okay, so we have. Okay, my next idea is to play rook e8 check. Let's play rook a check. Okay. Okay, so now I have this pawn on a6. Well, how am I gonna get it? Okay. Let's play this move. Yes, attack his rook and attack the pawn on a7. Which could be useful anyway. Okay, he's gonna take the pawn. I'm gonna take this. Okay. How am I gonna defend that pawn? Okay, let's just check first here. And I think I'm gonna win the rook. Now he's lost. I'm gonna win the rook. Okay, just yeah, with this increment, I should be winning. Check, stick with the queen. Yeah, this is a definitely won game. Yeah, let's take and then queen, another queen. And the game is totally over for him. I think he's gonna resign soon. No, he's not. Okay, let's get another queen. Queen g8 is made, no matter what happens. Yeah, okay, so we're gonna analyze that game. What did I do wrong? Okay, here I'm. Yeah, I know I can play d3 or something like that, but just want to transpose it to this sort of max Lynch attack. Yeah, was knight g5 the correct move? Oh, it's d5, d5, knight b8, and then knight c3, bishop e7, or knight c3. Okay, so how about my move? So my move is like not the strongest one. So yes, d5 takes. So the only move he has is knight takes d4, and then I had to play c3, knight f5, d6. Okay, so it's like knight d4. C3, knight f5, then d6. So I have a direct attack on the pawn, I think. Is it the best move? So he has to play knight takes d7. And I'm gonna play knight takes f7. Okay, so the computer says this is fine for black, but I don't know, if I was black, this is kind of scary playing this way. So anyway, knight d5 is a bad move. So apparently d takes e5 is the strongest move, or castling. Okay, but the move that I played was quite okay. Then check. Knight c3 was correct. Yeah, knight d4 was the one I'm worried. If he takes knight d4, bishop d5, check. But he played this thing, so knight d take e5. Yeah. I think my move is strongest here. Okay, here it seems to be d take e5 is the best, but I played castling, which is okay. Oh, okay, so the move that I chose, knight d5, is not the best. It's supposed to be bishop take e7. Yeah, okay. Bishop take e7, then d takes e5. I should have maintained that trash. Because if he took with a pawn, then yeah, it's still winning for me, but I think it's less clinical here. Okay, nothing, my screen is hanging, so he's going for the queen thing. Yeah, I should play h4 first to block the bishop g5 move. So yeah, this move is okay. King g6 is okay, king f8. Then h4? What do you mean h4? Can't he just take the bishop or something? Then play g3. What's the difference? There's a rook g4. I'm not sure I like this line. But anyway, the line that I played was g3, which is still okay. Okay, that was a blunder, but he had a move like bishop d7, and I had to play f4. Yeah, I think this is more better way to play f4. Yeah, here I think, yeah, I missed f5. e6 probably wasn't the best move. f5, yeah, was probably better because I had f6 after that, if he doesn't do anything. Yeah, let's see again. But e6 immediately is still winning. And took the pawn. Okay, I can't take the pawn, so I'm gonna play this check. Yeah, here rook e6 with h4. I think anything is winning, I just need to make sure I don't blunder. And here I think after b6 I played this move. And yeah, rook e8 check was the key move, just to simplify the position. And over here he's lost, because once he took the pawn, I had this check, and then he lost the rook. Yeah, so it was a nice win in the end. Yeah, and a good lesson for me. So the key memory marker here was yeah, I think here everything goes, but I think I played well. The only thing is I probably not exchanging the knight on d5 first was better, probably. Yeah, around about here, I think bishop take e7 was better. Because let's say if you take bishop take here, I can sort of prolong the fight. And prolong the tension, but yeah. Yeah, so this is the memory marker that I need to remember. So yeah, let's go to the next game.